Welcome to Healing Conversations with Coach V, with me, Coach V, Certified Life Coach and Personal Growth Expert with SVM Initiatives, LLC. So I am so excited about the guest I have here today. She really deserves like no introduction, but I'm going to let you know that I have Miss Ebony J, the host that does the most in the space today, to share with us her story of triumph, challenge, healing, and what she personally did to overcome and be the amazing host that she is today. So let's welcome Miss Ebony J. Welcome, ma'am. How
are
you?
Beautiful.
Thank you so much for making time to come into the space with us. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. Well, as we already talked about, we know that this show is all about healing, mm-hmm. our journey to healing, the path that you took, you know, to be all the diva fabulousness that you are today. But I always say that in order for people to appreciate who we are today, they really got to have a small glimpse into who we used to be or where we came from. So after we cover all of that, I would love for you to share with us the great things you got popping for the rest of this year, for 2018. So I want to make sure we get into all of that good stuff. But before that, not that you really need to, but introduce yourself to the audience. Let us know who you are.
Well, I am a queen of many hats. I am the host that does the most, Miss Ebony J, and I started off doing radio. I have a passion for speaking and a passion for teaching. So aside from starting off in radio at 101.1 The Wiz, I've now moved on. I'm now 100.3 R&B and old school.
Okay,
so
okay.
I have fun with the older crowd
right,
now,
right.
And I so love it. And aside from doing all of that, I teach over at the Ohio Media School,
okay.
where I'm teaching people how to, you know, be the next me or be their own selves.
Absolutely.
That's what I like to tell them. I'm teaching you how to be the next you.
Absolutely.
You. And so I do that, and I own my own business as well. So I own Ebony J Media LLC,
okay.
where I work with different people who do stuff like this, who do podcasts, who do
okay.
Have an inspiring goal to be in media,
mm-hmm.
and teach them and coach them on what's needed, and especially in public speaking. You know, it's not easy to get in front of a camera,
absolutely.
Nor is it easy to just to be interviewed and knowing, like, how do you actually work the interview, get the best
yeah.
out of your experience. So I coach people and help with that. And of course, you know, I work with my sister, Kim,
yes,
who has
yes,
developmental
yes.
disabilities. I love that girl
yes.
to pieces. And so, as you can see, my life story and my day-to-day really is filled with just helping others.
Now, let me just sidebar real quick, because I don't think the people know that I know Miss Ebony J before y'all knew who Miss
yes.
Ebony J was. So, for me to hear her bio, for me to hear the things that she's accomplished, I can like personally tell y'all, I knew her back when she was Tay-Tay. When she was
yes.
braiding, learning how to braid hair and telling me the dream she had and
mm-hmm.
how she had a passion for journalism and wanted to go to the Ohio Media School. So it is an honor, and I'm kind of trying to curb my excitement because she's sitting before me and I remember her saying, hey, this is what I want to do, while she learning how to do braids and install braid hair. So
yes.
it is like such an honor just for you to squeeze time in to come holler at me.
Oh, no.
In my space.
I appreciate
you know,
it.
And let us know and let everybody else know everything you got going on. So, whew, that was a big resume.
I know, right?
But
still
press
left
forward.
A whole bunch out because,
yes.
you know, God is just
yeah.
so good and
yeah.
he's so great. And what I like to tell people, you know, sometimes what we've been through is not the part that we need to focus on.
Absolutely.
We need to focus on, you know, the overcoming and
Absolutely.
How we are overcoming. And so I like to spend a lot of my time making sure I do that. I also am the vice president of the National Journalism Association. And I also have an I Am Queen program where I go
yes,
inside
I
the schools
that.
And the churches. And I'm talking with the young girls about being a queen and overcoming their triumph. Because we all have stories. We all
Absolutely.
Have journeys, you know. And all of our journeys are different, but it ultimately sets us up for who we need to be.
Absolutely. Now, I know everybody is like on the edge of their seat, like I'm trying to stay seated to hear about all that fabulousness. But as I mentioned, as a point of reference, just give us a little bit of your journey, where you came from, so we can really appreciate why you are, in fact, the host that does the most.
Well, ever since I was like 5, I always said I want to be a teacher, preacher, on the radio.
Oh, in that order. Okay.
And so my mom used to always, well, a lot of people used to say, you can't do all those things. Okay. Like, you need to pick one. Pick one, Ebony. Pick one, Jafiant. And I'm like, no, I really can't pick because I love them all. Right. But my mom used to always say, you can do all things through Christ that strengthens you.
Shout out to Mama Kim.
Yes, shout out to my mom. She's my biggest supporter. Yes. I love her because she's always kept me grounded. Mm-hmm. Despite what the world said or what anybody thought of me, she always let me know, you are beautiful. You are somebody. You are going to be somebody. You know, you are amazing. You are worthy. You know, I am queen. And so that is the gist of everything. You know, I tell people, be careful what you ask for because you just might get it.
Absolutely.
And so I asked him, I said, God, I want to be a teacher, preacher, and on the radio. And he said, all right. Mm-hmm. And so my journey has been full of so many different things. You know, having a sister with developmental disabilities, that's mm-hmm. its own triumph, its own situation. I also have been a victim of, you know, abuse. Mm-hmm. I've been sexually assaulted. I've tried to commit suicide. Mm-hmm. I've experienced domestic violence. Oh my goodness, the list goes on. I've had self-esteem issues. Mm-hmm. But you know, aside from them all, when I look back on my life now and I go talk to young girls and I see the platform I'm on or where God has me at, I understand why all of those parts and all those things happened in my life. And it was because He was preparing me for the audience. Yes. He was preparing me for the little girl who messaged me in my inbox telling me that she cuts herself because she has visions. Mm-hmm. He was preparing me to have those kind of conversations to help that woman who's trying to get out of that abusive situation that she's in, or that guy who's afraid to admit he's going through domestic violence right now because he is a man.
Right.
And so with him getting me through things, now I know it is my purpose to live on purpose. And that purpose is to help others. Absolutely. And so I tell him every day, use me, Lord. And I'm starting to realize it's not even my life. I want to go home and go to sleep. I can't go home and go to sleep because there's work to be done. Right. And wake up. We need you. We need you. And so it's constantly reminding me that, you know, we have to be great. It's not an option. Mm-hmm. It's not an option. You have to be great. And so I tell the women, you know, you are queen. I tell the kings, you are king, and you have to believe that you are, because it's not all glitz and glam.
Yeah.
I wish it was, but it's not.
Like, people just see the finished product.
Yeah,
they
don't see the work that goes into it. You don't see this brokenness.
Absolutely, absolutely. One of the points I want to make sure that we drive home is that, and it's something that I teach clients in my practice, whether it's individually or in groups, that it's all about changing our perspective and our mindset. You know, we get into a space where we experience so many horrible things, so many things that are in their own right negative and debilitating and make us feel like we don't want to go on. But when we shift our perspective and understand that we went through that for a reason, so that we can be more relatable to our audience, we can be more relatable to the person who reaches out to you on social media, that's strength in that.
Yeah.
And then we got that platform to say, boo, don't give up, because I've been there. And let me tell you the details.
Yes.
And then now look at me now. You know, that gives them power. That gives them encouragement. Mm-hmm. I can imagine you experience that a lot, right?
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, they really look up and be like, what? I mean, I was even talking to the girls today. I have my I Am a Queen program at Hughes Center, and speaking with them, you know, when I start telling them, because I keep it real brief, I don't want to stay on it, because we can't stay on the past.
Absolutely.
Because we can't go forward if we stay on the past. And so long, it took me so long, and it's still a challenge daily, to just let it go.
Yeah.
To let it go and to know it happened for a reason. Mm-hmm. But that's not easy for a woman who was molested almost every single day. That's mm-hmm. not, God, why would you do that to me? You know, why would you put me in that position? Right. You know, it's not fair. And for so long, you know, I had a whole broken heart about it.
Absolutely.
Because growing up, I was this church going, I mean, you know, church going, praying, leading the choir, directing everything in leadership. I was in this, I was there to do all this stuff. I was doing what I was supposed to do as God's child. But why is this my life every day?
Yeah.
Why is this my life every day? And it bothered me so much. So when it was time for me to go to college, I kind of was just like, in that roar, like, I done tried to commit suicide, it didn't work. Everything I done tried, it's not work. I'm still here, but I'm still upset. Mm-hmm. And really what saved my life was focusing on my dreams.
Okay. Now, do you think that at the point where you were questioning God, because a lot of us experience that, we want to feel like, hey, I'm doing everything you told me to do, everything my mama taught me to do, my grandmama taught me to do, but you're allowing me to be exposed to this foolishness. You're allowing me to be exposed to this foolishness. At the point that you were questioning and may not have been receiving the answers that you were looking for, what was the turning point that made you say, okay, let me choose to focus on my dreams. Let me let this go temporarily, not forget it, but let me let this go and get over this hurdle. What was that turning point for you?
Oh, I want to say the turning point is happening now.
Okay.
The turning point is happening now because I'm constantly being asked to speak at places. I'm constantly getting inboxes and having people express to me because they feel comfortable. So hearing what they're saying, like with the girl who keeps cutting herself, you know, my biggest thing is to pray. And I don't know how else to say it. It's starting to seem like people think it's cliche. Because I don't know how else to tell you to get through it besides how I got through it. And I know it was because people were praying for me. I know it was because I was praying. And so it's still a challenge. I can't say that it was one extreme circumstance. I want to say it's just with me being constantly challenged. And again, like I said, it's not my life. So every time these situations happen, I had to get up and go. Nobody could know. And so because I'm so used to that now, it's like, it's time to let it go. I want to be in a relationship. I want to have kids. You know, I want to get married, but I'm still dealing with so many issues, you know, sexually, with trust, with knowing, you know, feeling comfortable, wanting an extra companion or wanting to even be with a friend. I like to be alone when I go home. I'm with people all day. That's my job, you know? And so it's it's not easy to heal, and it's not easy when you decide to let it go neither, because you might still have a nightmare, a vision, something come on TV, love and hip hop. Now you trigger it, ready to be back in that emotion again.
So what do you think, how much of a role that you think self-care plays a part in healing or moving forward or letting go?
A big role.
Huge,
it's a huge role. You have to take care of yourself. And I think, oh my goodness, that might have been my turning point, was the taking care of myself. Starting to decide, you know, what does Ebb's time look like? What makes Ebony happy? And, you know, for so long it's been making other people happy or, you know, teaching or, you know, going and talk to somebody. But it's like, Ebony, if you didn't have no other people, what would make you happy? Well, I love to paint. I can't paint, but I love to go to like the sipping paints, the Litten paints, like shout out to Khalid Crenshaw. He's I'm always doing a collaboration with him. I told him that's my happy place. And so he does painting like every other week at a studio, prestigious studios on Claren. And when we go, you know, that's my only relaxation time, is to just paint and to have fun. Another thing that I've been doing is working out, exercising. And so I'm learning that it's more those emotions and those feelings that keep hurting me, it's more than those memories. It's about myself. And I've learned how the situations that I've been in play on how I view myself, how my insides really are and what I really think and feel. Like I might think I'm beautiful and saying this, but some days I've had that moment, or I might really subconsciously don't think I'm doing great. Even though people are saying you're doing so great, I still might be at home battling with that. And so I'm learning that you have to take care of you and make you feel great. What you setting those small goals.
And I wanted to hit home on that, because I know that the people listen to the host that does the most. You know, I believe that self-care is important also, but we just get in such a routine of just moving and going and wanting to be there for everyone else, that if we don't take care of Coach V, we don't take care of Miss Ebony J, we won't be here to help motivate anybody else. Absolutely. And I know the people listen to you, so let me, you know, let me see what Miss Ebony J thinks about this.
You have to take care of you. If you're not getting any me time, red light, ding ding ding, stop right now.
Do you hear me?
And that is the point, I think, for me, that it came, you know, this year, you know, having all these jobs and owning my own business. It was really a lot. Like, you look at my calendar, I'm going to the next event, but I'm tired. I'm overwhelmed. It's a lot. And I learned, like, no, look at your calendar. You don't have no spaces in your calendar. And you've been up since 5 o'clock. and it's now your home, and you're coming in here at 11:30,
yeah.
And you're telling me you didn't even eat today.
Yeah.
You're telling me you didn't even have a minute to yourself to think. Mm-hmm. You didn't go to the bathroom, Ed, literally, mm-hmm. seriously, no.
Yeah.
And so you have to really look in the mirror, look at what you're doing, mm-hmm. and really figure out, like, what are you running from?
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
that's the thing, what was for me. Maybe I'm running for something.
Staying too busy, you don't have to think about it or
so
deal
I don't
with
have
it.
To sit still and deal with
absolutely.
This pain.
Absolutely, absolutely. One of the exercises I teach my clients is that even if you work for someone else, if you work for yourself, just like you schedule meetings and appointments and events, you need to schedule and stick to a day for you.
Oh, yeah.
I don't care if you lay around the house all day. I don't care if you go get pampered. I don't care if you read a book, write a book.
Hold on. You paint. Say a day?
Yes, at
a
least.
A day?
At least.
I don't know if I can do no day now. I try
least,
to get
yeah.
3 or 4 hours yeah. in, but
And that's a step in the right direction. When you get deep into entrepreneurship, and I read so many books, you know, Jack Canfield and Think and Grow Rich, and yeah, the hustle in us is great.
Mm-hmm.
But as you said, if we're running on empty, all that hustling we're doing, we're not there to enjoy it.
You in the coach meeting, like, exactly. what? You trying to think? What
exactly.
she just say? Like, I mean, exactly. you really not there because yeah. you can't be there.
Yeah. So I teach a lot of people, even especially moms. You know, moms run around busy, but then too, because we're trying to juggle being a parent and some cases being a wife and building our business and working for others. So even if it's 15 minutes and put the house on notice from 6 to 6:15, this me. Don't knock, unless the house on fire,
yes.
somebody bleeding, handle it.
Yes.
And then you just learn to just add to that so that when you get to the point of a day, then you'll come back and be like, hold on, coach, you said a day, look, I done scheduled 2 days, Saturday and Sunday. I'm
out of here.
Week. You know, so it's baby steps. It's baby steps.
Yes.
But people have to be able to respect your time. They pull from you so much because you're great at what you do.
Mm-hmm.
So you say yes. But learning that gift of no,
oh yes,
is very powerful as well.
No has yeah. been like my best friend
yeah.
for the last couple of months.
Okay,
and
see,
sometimes
so you're
it really hurts me to say no.
Yeah.
Like it hurts me to the core. I'm
yeah.
sitting here sending a no text message and changing it to yes. I mean, I'm going through it. It hurts me to say no
yeah.
because I've been saying yes for so long.
Absolutely.
For everything.
Absolutely.
And I learned that the no's is what I be needing. I be
yeah.
needing that no time.
Yep, absolutely. And people gonna respect that. You, Miss Ebony J, you just got to show them how to treat you and
yeah.
get on board with that.
And that's what it is.
Yeah.
Because, too, people got to pay you for your time, too.
Yes,
and that's
yes.
what I learned. I was getting
yes.
a lot of volunteer opportunities. And I'm like, I got 10
yeah.
years in here. Y'all
yes.
don't NK, I did a
yeah.
lot of volunteering. 5
yeah.
years, free work, hosting free, doing free stuff, coaching, media.
Yes.
Like, I've done the free stuff for
yeah.
5 years straight.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started getting paid, like, more so, like, after graduation. So the gigs, like, I was getting before that, a lot of them was, you know, maybe, like, barter or help me or,
mm-hmm.
you know, giving me just
mm-hmm.
some gas money. But now, like, this is my business. This is how
exactly.
I eat, sleep, pay the bills.
Exactly.
And if you're not financing it, I can't keep helping make your dreams come true.
Yes. Yeah,
it come down to
yourself.
That. And again, and that's
absolutely.
Why I value, you know, having life coaches
mm-hmm.
like you who can tell us and teach us how to heal because
yeah.
we don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, there's no manual. We're not
uh-huh.
we're not given a manual. We're just put in situations and we understand later that, again, a cliche, that the test turns into a testimony.
Yes.
But that doesn't heal the brokenness. That doesn't,
doesn't.
Heal the wounds. So now we've been covered like so much already.
Yes.
But I really want to get to some of the things that you actually have going on, not just to help yourself heal, but to help others heal. I know about the program that you mentioned at Hughes, but I want them to know. I know about some engagement you have coming up, some events.
Well, actually,
let people know what you got going on.
It's a queen's movement.
Yes.
You know, it's about being a queen. And so long I've been waking up, good morning, kings and queens. You see it on my
yes,
Facebook
very
statuses
consistent.
For
mm-hmm.
years. You know, it's been about 10 years. And now I'm waking up and I see like 25, 30 people with Good Morning Kings and Queens.
Yeah.
So I had to start reminding myself, you know, when I first started saying, I'm like, what? Now they taking my stuff. I
right.
can't have nothing.
Right.
But then I remember a queen is quotable.
Yeah.
And so then, you know, I break down the word queens. And so it stands for quotable, unique, educated, empowered, noble servants. Because I believe we are all servants. Yes. We're here to serve. Mm-hmm. We're not here to do anything else but to serve. Find our purpose, live on purpose, and to serve. And so I put the Queen's program together, which really was just an idea.
Okay.
An idea. I had to start praying on the concept. There's different kind of queens. We got the Queen of Hearts, the Queen of Spades. You know, I break down each definition, each meaning, what each one means.
Okay.
And so definitely one event I want you to look forward to this year is the I Am Queen Awards. Last year was my first year doing it. It was for my birthday. The gift to me was to honor other women. Because you know, we all do great things and we want to be honored sometimes. You know, I want to be honored sometimes. So
true.
I'm like, let me honor other queens because I am queen, you know. So I did the I Am Queen Awards, and then it turned into having the I Am Queen shirts. So if you buy an I Am Queen shirt, the proceeds go to the I Am Queen scholarship that I'm actually going to be announcing the winner pretty soon.
So it's levels to this
movement. It's levels to this movement.
Okay.
And
okay.
So in learning, because it came from, again, just the Queen program, a teacher hitting me up and saying, my girl's over here bad. They need some help. Come through.
Just bad.
Bad. Okay. Okay. That was the word she used. They off the chain and they need some guidance. And we only have 6 weeks left. What can we give you? How can you make this happen? And I really put something together based off of the needs and the concerns. From that, other schools asked me, other maybe like pastors and different organizations have asked me to come talk. And then I started my contract with Hughes Center. This is my third year at Hughes. The crazy thing about that, and you know, again, like I said, you know, God is always putting me in the right places with the right people. And so after hearing about how things went at the Boys and Girls Club, she was really happy to have me at Hughes. And she was so happy to have me at Hughes, they hired me for the whole year.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And so I only had a 12-week program in my head.
Right.
I had to break down all this stuff down around
now
queens.
You gotta expound it.
Now I have to expound it. And so I started bringing other queens with me. And so I had different people like Morgan Orns coming, having working out with them. Emerald Sparks came, teaching them about finances. I had Angie come, helping them with the hair. I had Fly from I Kelly Ford coming and helping with wardrobe, and just different people coming and breaking down in different aspects. So it's not like I'm just using the platform that I have just to reach them. No, giving them other platforms, other mentors, giving them another point of view from a woman, because what I like, they just think we got it all together, queen.
Right.
They think we're living good.
I'm trying
to tell them the struggle don't stop. Stay young while you can.
Very consistent. We just learned how to make it look prettier.
Yes. Take me back to high school.
Make it look prettier.
Yeah. So after putting that together and her having me longer and really putting a program together, it was like, this year I'm coming all the way together with this will be an umbrella in the business. So it's Ebony J Media, but underneath Ebony J Media is the Queens Movement. And so the women were looking at my statuses and they were enjoying the vision boards and the affirmation parties we were having and the different events we were doing. And they like, we want to do it too. You don't do nothing like that for us.
Right.
And so I'm like, what? I don't know how I'm going to help make this work. And so a woman named Simone reached out to me. She had a new place. It's called Blush The Event Loft. It's downtown. She reached out to me and was like, I would love it if you can have an event at my location.
Wow.
And I'm like, what? I don't have events, ma'am. I don't know what you want me to put.
Don't block your blessings.
Anything that you think of, you know, pray about it and, you know, let me know. And I mean, she's the sweetest thing, the sweetest woman. She gave me the opportunity. I came up with an event, pieced it together, and I maybe had like 10 people come. This was in a location of 30 people.
Okay.
And so 10 people came. I was really heartbroken. It's like, it was my first event. Oh my goodness, I don't think I can do this anymore. Pineapples. And she was like, girl, you're not giving up. I wanted to cancel the event on the day of. But everybody that came was so inspired. I mean, it was so many tears in the room, so much healing. I'm like, now you're telling me I still got to do this one next month. And she was like, yes, your birthday. You said you want to do it. I Am Queen Awards.
Uh-huh.
What's up? Uh-huh. And so I put that event together and we reached capacity. And this was what I don't understand, but this is how I know it's nothing but God, because the event place was bigger.
Okay.
So the 30 people, I couldn't get 30 people in, I only got 10 people in the 30 space, but then when I get a space of 60, I get 80. I don't understand,
right.
Lord. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But so she really came to me with the idea to do the event, and I felt like the only way to do it was the women were asking for queen events.
Yes.
Now I have a location to do it, and boom, pieced it all together. And
listen
it's,
to the people.
It's
they'll
been going ever since.
They'll tell you what they need. And kudos to you on that move, and I understand how it can get really discouraging to put on an event, to put all your time and energy in it, and folks say they want to be a part.
Oh, yeah.
But they don't come through. So kudos to you for making that happen and then it expounding and growing past what you expected.
Oh, yeah.
What part of what you do for other people, and unfortunately, we're running out of time, but
okay.
I do want to know, what part about you giving back and doing for other people helps Ebony J heal?
Oh, this one I love. So while at NKU, I did the North Coast Radio, you know, online radio station. I had the Ebony J Show.
Mm-hmm.
Then I got hired at Radio One Cincinnati, and they kind of felt it was a conflict of interest, so I kind of wasn't able to do it anymore.
Okay.
So I kind of swept it under the table, kept trying to find ways to bring it back where I wouldn't be politically incorrect.
Right.
Long story short, October came up this year. Last
mm-hmm.
year, it was breast cancer awareness. I did a big social media campaign giving facts about breast cancer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This year, last year, I wanted to do it on domestic violence, but I wasn't ready. I didn't have the courage,
right.
But I heard God's voice telling me to do it. I didn't listen.
Right.
So this year, I decided to do it,
mm-hmm.
and I put different scenes together, different scripts, had different scenarios on the different types of abuse. And while doing that, it was really a big part of my healing because I was able to, like, think about perfect scenes, which gave me flashbacks from different scenes that I experienced
mm-hmm.
and different things that bothered me and affect me. So getting that story out was so much easier because it was able for me to, again, to see myself in a different way, but then look at other people's stories.
Absolutely.
And so hearing their stories, like I started getting a big flood of inboxes from men and women and
mm-hmm.
everybody was talking about their
mm-hmm.
situation and their story. And, you know, I didn't even have to really promote this event that big. People were just like reaching out to me. But what I learned from having the event that people were so scared, a lot of people weren't able to come or, you know, they let fear win. We
Absolutely.
Did have a good turnout. We
Absolutely.
Did have people come and share their story. And I always say numbers never matter to me. It's always about the people that come long as they get
yeah.
what they needed, and they did. And so I moved on to November having the whole campaign being about mental health
mm-hmm.
and having an event for that. And so I just think, you know, being able to help others and using my platform of media to tell stories and to talk to people and help with people and give them coaching advice, that has been the biggest healing.
Giving back to others.
Giving back
being
to others.
Being transparent,
yes.
opening up, and
keeping
being
it real.
And being
keeping
accessible.
It real.
Yes.
Because they
yes.
get to talking
yes.
and they talking
yes.
to me like, I don't know what they talking
yeah.
about. And then when I say, oh yeah,
yeah.
girl, I've been there too. What?
You gotta validate sometimes.
Yeah,
yeah.
I gotta tell
yeah.
you. You looking at the whole product right now, honey.
Yeah.
Look at these wounds. Take
yeah.
this off.
Yeah.
See me.
Yeah. So this has been like so amazing, and the time has like went really, really fast. But if you could, in one sentence, in 10 seconds, look at the people and tell them something encouraging and what encourages Ebony J, let them know.
Never give up. The best is yet to come. And soon as you're ready to give up, you're going to miss your breakthrough.
Absolutely.
Don't miss it. Keep going. And know that, again, the best is yet to come.
And tell the people how they can connect with you.
Please connect with me on social media. I'm at Miss Ebony J on every single social media you can think of. Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat. I'm on Tumblr. And you can also go to my website. I have different events coming up, of course. I'm always busy, so, and I always have different events that I'm hosting. If you need a host or any promotion for your next event, MissEbonyJ.com is definitely the place you need to go to.
I hope y'all got all of that. I hope y'all got it all. If you didn't, hit her up on social media
yes.
at Miss Ebony J.
Miss Ebony J.
On all platforms. I know she's on Facebook. I'm connected
yes.
with her on Facebook. So please follow her. Thank you so much for tuning in. I know y'all looking at the clock too, like, that's it? Yeah, that's it for today. So tune in with us next week for Healing Conversations with Coach V. That's me, Certified Life Coach and Personal Growth Expert with SVM Initiatives, LLC. Peace and love.
Yes. Great job.